Yes, how are you doing? Today I came with a bit more serious topic than usual, and that's about overtraining. Now, if you are new to sports, running or triathlete, you most likely didn't experience any of these symptoms on yourself. But if you are, for example, an age group triathlete in the sport for many years, then most likely you have already experienced some of this overtraining. Now, by no means I am a doctor or a psychologist. I have to really emphasize this. What I'm saying is based on my own experience as a triathlete and a coach and my studies as well. So I would like to really approach this topic from work perspective. If you have a burnout at work, how I see it, it's really based on a triangle. And the triangle has 3 points and three factors. That's the job itself, the colleagues, and the manager. If you are struggling at one of these three areas, for example, your job is too stressful, too many deadlines, too many tasks and such, then it's difficult, but usually you can cope with it if your colleagues and your line manager is really at your back and really helping you. But if two factors of these three are not there and you have really an issue out of those two of out of those three, then you have an issue. Example, your line manager is really not helping you. You cannot align with the person. And at the same time, you cannot make your deadlines, you cannot make your projects, you cannot make your tasks. Then it's usually the factor which is leading to a burnout. Now, our lives as age group triathletes, age group runners, with quite some goals, I see it also as a triangle. And that triangle has also three factors. First, work. Second, family, third, sports. Not in any particular order, of course. Usually, these three factors are at the balance. So that's why usually you are also hiring a coach to help you to create that balance, because it's just really difficult to find that balance yourself. If you need a coach for triathlon online coaching or running online coaching, you know where to find me, www.triathharder.com, or just leave a comment in the comment box below. That can really help. And then your coach makes your training schedule based on your work-life challenges. And then you really get there to accomplish your race goals, your sport goals. And still, the other two pillars will be in balance. You will have the time to spend with your family and to do also your work. Now, when, for example, you have challenges at your family life, disagreements with your wife or your husband, whatever, and also just the sport is getting too much. Usually, you are getting there overtraining. If you are working in triathlon, for example, in a 4-week cycle, then you know that for the third week, fatigue is really piling up. It will be just too much physically. But that's okay because it really is the overreaching what you need to go above and beyond your comfort zone, to really, really develop. And of course, agreeing with your coach, you have to know those limits, what you have to really pass, but not overreach too much. On the other hand, when you start struggling mentally, then you usually run an issue, and that's really overtraining. Of course, getting those trainings done mentally is also a challenge. But if the other two pillars, your work and your family, is in a balance and you can cope with it easily, then you have also the mental power to do your trainings and to really get your race goals. But if you are having challenges at one of the other two areas, usually that's the moment when you are getting overtrained and you really have to also be careful that it's not even a burnout there. Maybe just skip some races, some trainings. Get a week extra off, and then you can really, really get to a normal balance again from that overtraining period. Now, of course, there are some symptoms like you cannot sleep, you cannot get those powers on the bike what you would normally reach for that training, losing weight, or the other hand, just getting some extra kilos because you have been cheating. Depends on the individual, of course. But these are serious symptoms. So, my advice is in these cases, when you have these symptoms, really sit down with your coach. Or also, ideally, not or, but also, sit down with your partner, your children, your manager, whatever you are struggling with as well, and try to really get there and discuss those issues and try to solve these issues, because this can lead to a serious burnout. On the overtraining part, if you have those symptoms, really what I have just mentioned, try to have a few rest days, try to have an easier month, maybe don't do that B race, for example, just focus on that A goal and you can just change your training plan as well. And don't forget, age group athletes, in the first place, I still really say it's for our pleasure to be healthy and not really to get that personal best every time. Of course, it's great to have it, but if you have really a serious challenge with other parts of your life, maybe you have to consider let go one of the races, let go one of your goals, because the most important is that you are staying mentally and physically healthy on the long term. Sport is really important, but sport is not everything. It was a more serious topic, as I mentioned already in the beginning. I hope that I could give you some background really to think about. If you face something as of now or maybe in the near future, just think about why are you doing these things? What is your goal? What is it worth? And go there and really think about and try to solve. Sit down with these people, sit down with yourself and think about and really get back. Have a day off totally from sports, from work, whatever helps you. And you have to really find out what helps you, because you don't want to get there overtraining, burnout. If you can relate to any of this, please let me in the comment box below. I would really appreciate having you there and really start the conversations. Thank you very much and see you in the next video. Bye.